Hello friends, welcome to another video by Software Junkie, and in this video I'm gonna be shedding some light on the topic of high level versus low level languages. To start, I would just like to demonstrate how the actual conversion process of a simple source code file into machine code and then actually executing the program takes place. For that, I would just create a simple C program. Go to desktop, then create a directory, and then create source file. Here I'm using C language. I'll just print hello world here. Just a simple hello world application, nothing fancy. Now I'll compile the code. There are these two files in the folder. Now I'll just use this command objdump. So as we can see on the terminal for this program, the corresponding assembly level output would be this. And the output for this same program under Windows environment, it would be this. The assembly level output is slightly different because of the different platforms, and partially because this printf function here, its implementation is different for Windows than it is for Linux. So let's get back on the topic of high level language versus a low level language. So the language of the level defines that how far is the actual language is from the hardware level. It can also mean a low level language will provide less abstraction than a high level language. In the early days, C and C++ languages like this were considered to be high level languages. The reason for that was program written in a C or C++ language will eventually gets converted into the assembly language program and then to machine level language of ones and zeros, which can directly run on the hardware. A language of ones and zeros would be considered closest to the hardware, and then comes the assembly language. It's essentially just the mnemonics for these instructions. There would be a corresponding binary level code, and when converting a assembly language program to a binary program, just this mnemonic would be substituted with its binary code. For the purpose of simplification, I would like to explain things using a diagram. On the lowest level is machine level language. It's just in the form of ones and zeros, and it is what could actually run on the hardware. Then comes the assembly level languages, which are just mnemonics in place of binary codes, and it's still a conversion step towards machine code. Then comes languages like C and C++, which are a step up from the assembler because you get to specify what you want to do, but in a slightly more abstract way. And also there's a concept of classes, which further abstract things away from the hardware level. And then comes languages like Java and C sharp, which take things further up the hierarchy, and you don't have to worry about pointer manipulation, garbage collection, memory leaks, etc. And then on the top of the hierarchy would be declarative or domain specific languages. In these languages, you just say what to do, and you don't need to specify how to do that. Like for example, in SQL you would just say select star from table and order by age, and you don't need to specify that what kind of sorting, whether quick sort, merge sort, or whatever SQL engine would have to carry out. The engine will work out the most efficient way to carry this out for you. Another example of a domain specific language would be NetLogo, which is kind of agent oriented programming language, and it's used in artificial intelligence programs. These domain specific languages are on top of the hierarchy because you don't know behind the scenes what algorithms are being followed to carry out the task. So the concept of high level languages versus low level languages, it just depends on level of abstraction from the actual hardware level, and it's a relative term. For a C programmer, assembly level language would be a low level language, and for a Java programmer, C would be a low level language. These are just relative terms, and you should not pay much heed to which languages fall into which category. I hope I'm able to explain the topic properly. Thanks for watching.